Oh. the backhand loop. You can start, you can go close to the table loop or away from the table loop. You can shoot.
So, what's the definition of loop?
Anybody know?
Arc.
So, there's no right answer, but the way I put it is this. Looping is a technique that you're trying to maximize the spin efficiently. So it doesn't mean that you need to go at full speed to generate full spin, but it's about depending on how much you put into the ball, like how much energy you're transferring to the ball, all of the energy is going towards spin, not speed. And once you reach good balance of spin and speed, then you can start to add speed without losing spin. So therefore it becomes power loop. Okay, so to begin the loop is first need to feel how the rubber is working when the ball hits your pedal. So there are typically three positions to make the backhand loop. When the ball is rising, when the ball is at the top, and when the ball is falling. Okay, and this point you can control with your spin. If you have a good spin, then the ball will come out low. That means if you stay closer, then will be, you have to hit it when it's rising. And when you're far, and your ball doesn't have much spin, and when they drop, the ball is too short, then you cannot loop. So always start close to the table. Oh, you will begin with like hitting the loop at the top first, and then little bit go back, catch the ball when it's falling. And then, lastly, come close to the table and then use the brushing technique to hit it on the right. Because at the top, and when it's falling, it's much easier to do the backhand loop than to catch here, because you don't have much time. So this technique, you cannot really use well in the game. But these two techniques, you may have more chance to make the shot. So, but I'll go from here first. So here, when you're staying close to the table and you want to brush the ball, mainly you're using a little bit of knees, and you're upward, down, and up like that, and together. And you don't need to combine left and right. Why? Because my pedal just needs to go down and up to brush the ball. And here on the right, it means the ball has a lot of energy. So I don't need to work hard. You have to just catch the right timing. So it looks like this. I'll go slow. Here, 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 here. Stay relaxed. Stay relaxed. Just brush. Timing, timing, timing. Not tense. Timing. Brush, brush. And then at the top, here, you need to start to use a little bit of down to the left, weight from the left 10%, compress it down, and then start to use a little bit of rotation, but still focus more on this part. You use this part. So it looks like this. And then when the ball is falling, you will need to go down, push more, and then make the shot. Okay, use the body. Body. Now, arm is this. Okay, you can feel the difference. If I initiate my shot with arm, that means I have to get tense. Because why? I have to use my arm. That's how you get tense. But your body, the way you use it is you can already make the swing with your body that adds to your swing. So if my swing is from here to here, when I move my body, my shoulder should stay in that swing line to make the shot. So here, relax. One, two, one. One, two, one, two, one. So arm is not only working that much, it's your body that makes
that's the
moving motion.
That's the shot!
To make God, I need to make that shot. So you should start slow. Start slow using the body. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Body, 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 body. Start slow. And then start to add speed, because we're focusing on speed, not speed. Okay? So the elbow is actually locked to generate the spin. In this case, his elbow is actually fixed, making his rotation of the lower arm, which is coming from the shoulder, to generate the spin. That's the first thing, that's the first default. The second difference is, if he does that, if he doesn't change the angle of the pedal, then it just goes out that way. But he maintains the angle of the pedal throughout that rotation. So therefore, it's pretty consistent to generate the spin. So, in other words, the way the pedal should move is like this, to face spin. But our body is not designed to make a linear slope like that. So we have to actually make a little bit of a circular movement. And to create that, we're kind of doing this, right? So this becomes hands here. But here with that, we can do one, two, and maintain it at the end. Yeah, maintain the angle towards the end. So that's what he's doing.
Here on
shoulder spin or top spin or side spin. Each point. So think about a point. Oh, it's a game. I'm not really good at handling these middle shots. I'm not waiting or I'm rushing. Or like short ball. I'm not going there deep enough. Or when I make a shot, always I give you a point. High ball, so therefore they attack. So think about what is your weakness and practice just that specific shot.
No!
It's forehand flip, backhand flip, it's medium, I want to get better in pushing, or looping for underspin, looping for underspin, or topspin, or topspin. And as you practice, another thing that you can think about is these spots are where you should try to serve. To see what's their weakness. Okay, your serve needs to be versatile, that you can put it here, you can put it here, you can put it short here, medium, which is second mount is here, and then very short. And then after that, you can make a sequence, making connection from one shot to the other. But first, you need to be able to also play each shot from these six spots. So think about what is your weakness. So one person will start again, the start first. Practice what you want to practice, then we'll switch back. Did you understand what I said?
Yeah.
Okay. So this side can start first.
Just drop the body and then
You can do that too. That's another way to do it. If you are not good at, like, if you're afraid of using the two times, because you're thinking too early, which is really hard. And it's close to bad. And then you just don't think. So let the ball wouldn't be high.
But ideally, I can't practice
on. If you're good at taking the far one, if you don't miss the shot, like if you don't miss making the shot from here, then you can start to really be close, not like all the way here. Okay. You always need to have space in this one. So like, for example, my long side is like here. Good way to play. And here is one space. Right side is ready for the long side, which forces the opponent to serve. So standing close is a trend that right among the professional players. But it's very difficult in front of the pretty clean. So it's not easy to too soon.
I would rather have you like very dive maybe and then make a better loop. And to stay close and make a like a not too close. So they can
put it on the cover.
But when you're back here, it's not too hard to see the snake.
Right. Uh-huh.
And never go to their back hand side. Always go to their back hand side.
Okay. Why not the back hand side?
Because their pendulum serve already has nice control. You will basically get there. Okay. You always go there, go to the
Try
to go even more forward.
Thank you.
Because I think it's over there. Yeah. Make them use forehand, therefore their return becomes here.
Thank you. Thank you.
需要。
So Fran, you can come out. Karen, you go up.
Should we start?
Yeah, start.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, 5 times and then done.
It's too short for him.